السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Dear colleagues and friends, welcome back to our sessions and our tasks from the Part 3 exam. Today we are going to talk about a new task. It will be about the maternity dashboard. It is one of the recall stations in the Part 3 exam. And why I chose this task for this week? Because it is one of the tasks that will make a difference between the UK candidates and the overseas candidates. For the overseas candidates, they are not used to this part of the practice. It is part of the clinical governance, which is not part of the daily practice of the overseas candidates. So to close the gap or to reduce the gap between those who are working in the NHS and those who are going for the Part 3 exam from outside UK, we will go today through the maternity dashboard. This station came before in the exam. It was a structured discussion task to assess your clinical skills in patient safety, the applied clinical knowledge, and the communication with colleagues. So you will be the ST5 in the labor ward. And in 10 minutes, your consultant is going to have a discussion with you about the maternity dashboard. During these 10 minutes, you are expected to answer the following questions. Number one, what is the maternity dashboard and what is the goal of it? The second question is how it is displayed and what are the parameters that are included in the maternity dashboard? The third question, how does it work? And then the next one, who should have the responsibility for filling the maternity dashboard and why? Then who should have access to the maternity dashboard? The sixth question will be about the advantage and disadvantage of the maternity dashboard and what actions that needs to be done based on the trends that will be discovered on the maternity dashboard. And here in this dashboard, there is a trend of increasing number of cesarean sections. So you will be asked what are the possible causes of this increased number of cesarean sections, and also you will be asked if you noticed that there is increased number of sickness leaves, what could be the cause for this. So we will go through these questions one by one and we'll give the appropriate answer for each one. So the first question, what is the maternity dashboard and what is the goal for it? Okay, the maternity dashboard is a virtual display tool. This tool was first used by the Royal College in 2008. It was used to monitor the performance of the maternity unit against the standards, and this standard will be agreed locally, and it is done on monthly basis. The standard here will be according to the local trust or the RCOG guidelines. So again, it is a virtual display tool used to monitor the performance of the maternity unit against the standard which are agreed locally. And the dashboard, it is done on monthly basis. What is the goal of the maternity dashboard? The goal is to monitor the performance of the unit and allow early intervention. If you face or if you discover any deviation from the standard practice, so it will be discovered easily on the maternity dashboard and the early intervention will be taken. Number two, it ensures continuous improvement in the clinical care. If you are avoiding mistakes, if you are avoiding any deviation from the standard, so you will correct it, so there will be improvement in the clinical care. Also, it is used to safeguard the clinical practice and as a clinical governance tool. So again, it is a virtual display tool used to monitor the performance of the maternity unit against the standard, and it is done on monthly basis. The goal is to improve the performance of the unit and allow early intervention to correct any deviation from the standard. Number two, it ensures continuous improvement in the clinical care. Number three, it used as to safeguard the clinical practice, and it is a part of the clinical governance tool. Next question, how it is displayed. The maternity dashboard it should be made in an easy way to be interpreted. So they used the idea of the simple cars, dashboard, and also the idea of the traffic light system. So if we can see here, this is the car dashboard. There is an indication for the amount of fuel, indication for the battery, indication for the doors. So you are discovering any deviation from normal to avoid going on the road without enough fuel, or it follows the idea of the traffic light system. So it used the three colors here. And each color is an indicator for an action. So if it is green, means the goals are met. We are following the standard. If it is amber, it means the goals are not met, but still we are within the upper threshold. Means there is an action is needed to restore it to the green color. But if it persists, it needs an attention from the trust board. So now we have two colors. Go green means go, the goals are met. Amber means the goals are not met, but we are still within the upper threshold. So the upper threshold is not breached yet. If it is red, it means that the upper threshold is breached and immediate action is needed from the higher authorities. So now we answer two questions. What is the maternity board? What is the goal for the maternity dashboard? And how it is displayed? The third question, what are the parameters that are included in the maternity dashboard? There are four major parameters that are included in the maternity dashboard. Under each one, there are some other parameters. So the first parameter that's included in the maternity dashboard is the clinical activity of the maternity unit. The clinical activity here, for example, it includes the number of booking or the number of admissions, the number of deliveries, the number of cesarean sections and operative vaginal deliveries, and the number of the transfers from the midwifery unit. So these are the clinical activities, and these will be determined according to the practice or according to the services which are provided by the unit. So it differs from one unit to another one. So number one, the clinical activity. Number two is the workforce. The workforce, it includes the number of sickness leaves, the number of attendants, the midwives to the delivery ratio, and the number of hours of consultant presence. These are examples of the workforce parameters that are included in the maternity dashboard. The third parameter will be the clinical outcomes. And the clinical outcomes in the maternity dashboard will be classified into maternal morbidities and neonatal morbidities. The maternal morbidities including, for example, eclampsia, major hemorrhage, which means more than 2,500 ml, blood transfusion, massive blood transfusion, failed operative vaginal delivery, shoulder dystocia, or obstetric anal sphincter injury. The neonatal morbidities, for example, herpes palsy that results from shoulder dystocia, hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy, and unexpected admission to the special care baby unit. So the clinical activity, the workforce is number two. Number three is the clinical outcomes, including maternal and neonatal morbidities. And the number four is the risk incidents, the complaints, and the patient satisfaction surveys. So these are the four parameters that should be included in the maternity dashboard. Four major parameters. Under each parameter, there are subdivisions that will be divided or will be decided according to the services and the activities of the unit, and it will be different from one unit to another. How does it work? How you are going to do a maternity dashboard? So number one, you have to select the parameters that suits the unit. So the parameters of the consultant lead unit will not be the same parameters of the midwifery lead unit. So the parameters that suits the unit according to the service provided will be determined or will be selected. Then we'll do benchmarking. What is benchmarking? Benchmarking means we are setting agreed standard against the performance against which our performance is monitored. And we mentioned before that this standard will be agreed locally, or we will follow the national guidelines. So number one, selection of the parameters. Number two, benchmarking. Standard, we are selecting a standard against which our performance is monitored. Then we are dividing the dashboard into green. Again, means the goals are met. Ambers means the goals are not met, but we are still within the upper threshold. Red means that the upper threshold has been breached and we need an immediate action from the trust board. Finally, we have to do this and monitor this on monthly basis. So the maternity dashboard is on monthly basis. It has to be changed and has to be monitored on monthly basis. So this is the answer for this question. How does it work? The next, who should have the responsibility for filling the maternity dashboard? The one who is filling the maternity dashboard is the one who has clinical risk perspectives. This includes the risk manager and the lead midwife who's working closely with the lead consultant for the labor ward. So risk manager, lead midwife, and the lead consultant working in the labor ward. These are the people, especially the lead consultant and the lead midwife, who can identify areas that needs to be monitored to avoid any deviation from the normal. This will be decided according to the practice of the unit or the labor ward. Who should have access to the maternity dashboard? Simply, anyone can have access to the maternity dashboard. The entire maternity team, everyone in the maternity team should have an access to the maternity dashboard. Also, everyone needs to see it locally. For example, the clinicians, whatever the specialty, the managers in the hospital, the commissioners, the patients. So the maternity dashboard will be displayed everywhere so anyone can have an access to it to increase the awareness of the staff all over the hospital. So another question, is the included data or are the included parameters are static or dynamic? I think we already answered this question. The data are dynamic. What is the meaning that the data are dynamic? It means differ between units according to the service provided. So there is no constant or there is no fixed parameters in the maternity dashboard between the trusts or between the units. Each unit should have its own maternity dashboard that will be decided according to the service provided by the unit. Even the same unit has to change the maternity dashboard after obtaining a compliance. So if you are monitoring certain activity, like for example, the number of cesarean sections and the compliance has been achieved, you achieved the goal, which is less than, for example, 23% of the number of deliveries will be cesarean section. So as long as the number of cesarean is stable, blows the standard, so you achieved your goals, so you can change this parameter and choose another one. So are the data or are the parameters included in the maternity dashboard are static or dynamic? They are dynamic. It differs between the units and it differs between months. It differs between months in the same unit once the compliance has been achieved. What are the advantage and disadvantage of the maternity dashboard? Let's start by the advantage. Simply, remember the three colors. We mentioned that the green means we have achieved the goal or the goal has met. So this is a good clinical practice. So the advantage, it identifies and promotes areas of good clinical practice. If the practice is unsafe or it has breached the upper threshold, it means this is unsafe clinical practice. So the maternity dashboard, it identifies the unsafe clinical practice to change it. If it is amber, means we are identifying the areas that needs improvement. So identify and rectify areas that needs improvement. So these are the main advantages. Identify and promotes areas of good clinical practice, identify unsafe clinical practice to change it, identify and rectify areas that needs improvement. This all finally will lead to improvement in the quality of care, and it increases the staff awareness about local issues. So how to increase the staff awareness? By showing the maternity dashboard everywhere, in the meeting rooms, in the dining rooms. Also, from the advantage, it can be used as a clinical governance issue or a tool. So it can be used in audits, and it can be used in risk management. And very important part, it compares the activity of the hospital against the peer hospital, or the activity of the unit against peer units in the same area. So these are the advantage. It identifies a good clinical practice and promotes it. It identify unsafe clinical practice and change it. It identify and rectify areas that needs improvement. This all will increase the quality of care and increase the staff awareness about any local issues. It can be used as a clinical governance tool, and it can be used to compare our practice against the peer hospital. What are the disadvantages of the maternity dashboard? It needs dedicated manpower. It needs commitment. So it needs dedicated manpower. It needs proper data collection and IT system participation. So it needs more work. So it is considered by some as a more workload and extra paper work. So these are the advantage and disadvantage. So what are the actions that can be done based on the trends? The trend means that you observe a certain deviation from the clinical practice, a certain deviation from the standard that you put from the local guideline or from the national guideline, from the local agreed protocols or from the national guidelines. So there is deviation. This is called a trend. So what are the actions that can be done based on the trend? You can do board meetings, you can do audits, and you can do feedback sessions. From the board meetings and audits and the feedback session, you will come out with recommendation to change or to improve the practice in this part to avoid deviation from the standard. So he will give you in the exam the maternity dashboard, and he's going to tell you, can you tell me about the trends in this dashboard? And what are you going to do? So for example, this maternity dashboard, when you see it, how to answer in the exam, you can say, for example, this is a maternity dashboard of, for example, whatever the name of the hospital, and covering the period between January and September. I can see here that this trust has chosen the following parameters. Again, our parameters, the activity, the main parameters, the activity, the workforce, and the clinical outcomes. Then you will go to the complaints, patient satisfaction, and risk incidents. So regarding the activity, you can comment, you can say that this unit chose the number of births or the benchmarking here to be 5,000 cases per year, which means 420 per month, and the number of booking 450, the number of instrumental vaginal delivery, the goal is 10 to 15%, the number of cesarean section is less than 23%. This will be the goal, and there are red flags. So if the number of births is more than 450, this means constant strains over the unit. This means more than the unit can maintain the proper service, and the number of booking is more than 100. If the number of instrumental deliveries is less than 5 or more than 25, this is a red flag, or the number of cesarean is more than 25. So this is regarding the activity of the unit. Regarding the workforce, I can see that this trust has chosen the number of hours that are covered by the consultant, the ratio between the midwife and the birth, the supervisor to the midwife ratio, and the training program and the attendance. The clinical outcomes, it includes the maternal morbidity and the neonatal morbidity. The maternal morbidity here, eclampsia, the number of ICU admissions, the blood transfusion, more than 4 units of blood, and postpartum hysterectomy, and the neonatal morbidities, the number of meconium aspiration, the number of hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy, and here the risk incident or the risk management cases which has shoulder dystocia, which has third degree perineal tear or failed instrumental delivery, and the complaints, the number of complaints, and the patient satisfaction. So these are the parameters that are included here in this dashboard for this trust. This trust has chosen these parameters, and the trust put certain goals and red flags, how to measure it, and the comment about and the documentation or the ethics. Then we will see. If we see here, green again means goals are met. Amber means we are above the lower threshold, but we are still within the upper threshold. But red means the upper threshold has been breached and an immediate action has to be taken. The amber means if it is persistent, means it is repeated from February, March, April, and May. This means this is a repeated amber. There is a constant or repeated trend of increased the number of cesarean section. So an action has to be taken to correct it again into green to achieve the standard. When you are commenting about certain trend, don't comment about it alone. Don't comment about a certain trend alone. You have to search for other associated trends in the same month. So for example here, if we are looking from February to May, there is increased number of cesarean sections, the more than the goals, which is less than 23%. If we look here, we noticed also that there is a trend in the midwife to birth ratio. So there is decreased the number of midwife in relation to the number of births, and a decrease in the number of supervisors in relation to number of births. So what we can say here, that there is increased the number of cesarean section, it may be related to decreased the staff number, and it may be related to increase the number of admissions or increase the number of births. So this is a way how to explain the trend in the maternity dashboard. What are the actions? What are the comments? So for example, here they noticed increased the number of cesarean section, so they increased the senior evaluation, the senior attendant. So they increased the number of hours of the consultant presence. So the color, it changed from amber to green. So they corrected the goals which are not met. So they corrected it and it becomes green in color. So this is a way how to explain certain trend in the maternity dashboard. Here the examiner will ask you, you noticed an increase the number of cesarean section rate, mention some possible causes. So the possible causes here will be lack of senior output. So the recommendation was to increase the number of hours of consultant attendance. It may be due to increase the number of admissions or increase the number of deliveries in total. So it will be relative increase in relation to the increased rate of admission and increased in rate of deliveries. Also, another cause, the new junior staff. The new junior staff also needs more support from the consultant. That's why the recommendation was to increase the number of hours of consultant presence, and also lack of training on instrumental deliveries. The juniors, they don't have the experience to use the instrumental deliveries, so they are going directly for cesarean section. And please do not comment about certain trend without commenting about other trends in the maternity dashboard. So as we discussed, when we mentioned the trend of increased the number of cesarean section, we searched for another trends that are related to the increased the number of cesarean section in the same period. We found that there is decreased the number of staff, decreased the number of midwives to births, decreased the number of supervisors. So these are other possible reasons of increased the number of cesarean section. You noticed that an increased number of sick leaves rate. So what could be the cause? It may be due to increased the workload with staff burnout. So they are searching for a way to escape from the overload in the work. There is unmet training needs. They are unqualified and they are searching for training, but they cannot find it. And there are management problems. There is problem with the administration, or there is need to interpret. Also, there is need to interpret other parameters. As we said before, if you notice an increased trend, like the cesarean section, like the sick leave rate or the sickness leave rate, you have to search for the other parameters or the other trends in the maternity dashboard. These are all the possible questions in this station. Again, this is a recall station. It is very simple, very easy if you know it, but it will be very difficult if you didn't see it before or if you are not used to see a maternity dashboard in your workplace. Hope this was beneficial for you. If you find it useful, please remember me in your prayers and share it with your friends, please. See you next week, inshallah. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.